Okay, this time I will speak how I approached the theory of Boscovich. Indeed, it started in 1971, when I finished my university study as a chemical engineer. I was employed in one petrochemical complex in a factory for the production of low-density polyethylene. This is a process discovered in 1933 by English company ICI. Empirical chemical industry. As a young engineer, I wanted to upgrade my knowledge. I read a lot of articles and books about the theoretical aspect of this process. One of the first I read was one chapter published in one book and written by Eric Hunter. From the company ICI, he worked at that time in that company. I noticed in his explanation that this process is performed at very high pressures, up to 3000 bars. And he explained why it is necessary to have such high pressure. He explained that ethylene molecules as in gaseous state are compressed very, very strongly, and they are organized, properly arranged, packed and deformed. That was published in 1953, as I remember. I tried to find how it is published, how it is packed, how it is arranged, try to find some another article published by this Eric Hunter. But there is no one other article. There are a lot of other scientists in England, in Germany, in Russia, in United States, but nobody developed this idea published by Eric Hunter. So me and my colleagues in that factory in Serbia try to pack somehow these molecules to explain this process following the recommendation given by Eric Hunter. But there was no success. It was happened that at one moment I looked at the Union bookstore and found a book. The name of this book was Dialectic of Nature, written by Friedrich Engels. I knew for Engels because he was a close friend and collaborator of Karl Marx. They are founder of communism. I know them as a theoretical of communism. And in that time I lived in a communist country. But when I look at this book, Dialectic of Nature, I found some chemical formula, some mathematical relationship, some calculations. Okay, that's it, something new. I didn't know Engels analyzed such phenomena. So I bought a book and read the book, and just read 7/10 of pages. And I look how he analyzed the phenomena in nature. Book was written in 1870s, 1880s. And all phenomena Engels explained by attraction and repulsion. He came to this idea about attraction and repulsion based on research of Hegel, German philosopher Hegel. But Hegel came to Kant, and all of them got this idea from old Greek philosophy. So, when I read several tens of the pages of Friedrich Engels and this story about attraction and repulsion, everything was clear for me. Now it was possible to follow the recommendation of Eric Hunter and to arrange and pack these molecules of ethylene in this process. Explain this. And problem was solved. from theoretical aspects and also from practical aspects, because there was no good theory of this process, and there was some problems in the industrial process. Now we were able to solve also the some industrial processes. We have published a lot of scientific articles concerning this process, but for me it is very important to see those philosophical aspects. Industrial aspects, okay, but philosophical aspects. See, those story about attraction and repulsion of Friedrich Engels was written in the middle of the second part of 19th century. Structure of atoms was not known. Quantum mechanics was not developed. Theory of relativity was not developed, because there is a huge progress of natural sciences after he wrote this book. So I was curious, maybe those ideas were developed, particularly in the communist countries where I am living. So I tried to find further development of this concept of Friedrich Engels, including the modern science achievements. I read a lot of articles, books, visiting many institutions, libraries. There are a lot, enormous quantity of the articles and papers written by many other scientists from those Eastern communist countries about this book, The Ethics of an Age. There are tons and tons of papers and articles, but no one, absolutely no one article mentioned that Engels even tell something about attraction repulsion. It is totally not ignored, but nothing is mentioned. So I visited some professor of philosophy. There is in Belgrade at Faculty of Natural Sciences, there is a department for philosophy of natural sciences. So I contact those professors, asking them about that problem that Engels only spoke about attraction repulsion, and it is not commented later. They were confused. They sent me to Professor Bogdan Šešić. He is one old professor of philosophy, but very well informed about the physics. He wrote several books about philosophy of physics. I discussed with him, but he was also surprised. Then he only recommended me, read the Boscovich. There is a lot of stories, say, about attraction repulsion, but in the same time, he sent me to some scientific meeting, which is occurred just in next month, and in this scientific meeting, philosophical meeting, more correctly, about this book, The Ethics of Nature. So I went on that meeting. There was about 100 philosophers and scientists, and I informed them what Engels wrote about attraction repulsion and asked them to help. Do you know something about that? They were totally, not say confused, but surprised. They didn't know. They know nothing. So, after that, those Professor Šešić sent me to the meeting of devotees to the Hegel philosophy. And the story is repeated. Also, they were surprised. So, then I read the book of Boscovich and understand that this is a very serious story. But later on, I included the other philosophers, starting from the old Greeks, and there is in philosophy, starting from old Greeks, Middle Age philosophies, and some modern, a lot of story about attraction repulsion, but this is completely missed by scientists and philosophers. I think that's enough for this part of the story.
Okay. Stop.
Stop.
Yeah.